I'm really proud to launch the third phase of the Nansen program, a state-of-the-art research vessel, the third Dr. Fridtjof Nansen. This ship and this program has been consequential and will be consequential. I'm really so thankful for the unique collaboration we have had with FAO in the spirit of Nansen. And here in my office in front of Dr. Fridtjof Nansen, it is also very touching to think and reflect on all what this program has meant for developing countries in Africa when it comes to improving coastal management, introducing more sustainable fishery policies. All this is necessary to really make sure that we take care of our oceans, make sure that the oceans are not filled with litter and plastic, but are real blue oceans that can also feed the world and billions of new people in the future. A prerequisite for doing so is making sure that we have a real scientific base for all what we are doing, making sure that it is in the best spirit of sustainable development. And with this program and with the research vessel, we are better equipped than at any time.
State-of-the-art, multi-purpose research vessel, the Dr. Fridtjof Nansen, hits the water prior to its final outfitting. This is the third ship launched in a unique partnership between Norway and the Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations. Research coordinator Torre Stromme has worked on board the previous two Nansen ships.
Standing here looking at this vessel, about to be finished, and will be sailing within a half a year or so, it is for me personally surprising to see that this project is around after so many years.
So even if we are looking now 40 years backwards, I would say quite optimistically that we can also now project our vision 20 years forwards.
Over four decades, the Nansen research vessels have sailed the equivalent of 60 times around the globe. They have discovered new resources and collected valuable data to help coastal developing countries manage their fisheries and protect their marine environments. Using sophisticated technology, scientists measure the ocean properties, including temperature, salinity, and oxygen. Trawl nets capture what is in the sea at different depths to monitor fish stocks. The seabed is mapped using echo sounders, and sediment samples are scooped up for analysis in the ship's laboratories. Scientists from survey countries join the work on board, counting and identifying their finds. All data and information is entered into a database, providing a snapshot of the state of the ocean. With regular monitoring, changes in sea properties, fish numbers, and entire marine ecosystems become apparent. Coastal communities are often most affected by these changes, as loss of resources they rely on can devastate local economies. Owned and shared by survey countries, the database provides essential information for the development of fisheries policies, leading to better and more sustainable use of ocean resources.
The data from the survey is going to help us first to establish the spawning areas Secondly, it's also going to help us to establish conservation areas. And then thirdly, it is going to assist us in the management of our fish stocks.
This new Nansen is designed to be bigger and even better, and is particularly equipped to gather more information to understand and address climate change and pollution impacts on marine ecosystems. Ship design coordinator Morten Eskedal points out particular features of the vessel's engine room.
All the three generator sets and all related rotating equipment in this room is elastically and flexibly mounted to the ship's hull to avoid the exposure of radiated noise to the sea.
A super silent engine will reduce the disturbance to sea life, allowing more accurate monitoring. And a dynamic positioning system will enable the ship to work safely around sensitive infrastructure like oil rigs.
You see all these dangling bundles of cables and so on, and this is going to be a bridge, and that's the captain's domain. So here, this is all the instruments for the navigation of the ship and for the movement of the ship. And we will proudly show them this room because this will show the best advantages of Norwegian design, ship design, and Spanish shipbuilding. This is a great upgrading of the previous Nansen. We have some unique new features, and also that we can work multi-purpose, that we can combine teams and working at the same time.
The ship will accommodate more scientists and additional specialized laboratories, enabling wider collaboration. Facilities for onboard lectures and seminars will develop and strengthen knowledge. Teams of workers are highly focused on the final outfitting phase before the sea trials and the ship's maiden voyage.
The needs for this type of research is very high, especially in the developing part of the world, for improving the fisheries. And then the long-term other needs is more on the global public goods, for have a monitoring system for the whole planet when it comes to the state of the oceans.
The new vessel is almost ready to take on the challenge to build on the previous four decades, improving, updating and sharing knowledge to protect the world's oceans and their resources.